circle of Evelyn's life. I was known as Evelyn's dad. I had no other name but Evelyn's dad. And like her of life, and with the other, I was the bank of dad. Now, in regards to me doing a talk like this, I must inform you, the last probably 5, 10 times I've done something like this, I was holding a musket in my hand.
Take Mary, my daughter.
Maybe the next occasion, Vanessa. Anyway, back then I was more scruffy. Beard, mustache, long hair, and a kind of stick with bad smell. Anyway, probably about 4 or 6 weeks ago, I posted on Facebook that I was going to be the father of Brian. And I had quite a few hits. People saying this, that, the other. Somebody asked me, what are you going to do with my cousin? I said, well, my older sister's time, my older sister's time. Well, my kid is still there. Well, let's start at the beginning, 1984. Famous things happened. The film Ghostbusters came out. The CD-ROM is invented. The Apple goes on sale, and of course, little Evelyn is born. She's born at a hospital that probably no longer exists. She's on an Air Force base that has been closed down. But it was close to Victorville, and what's famous for Victorville? It's the Warren Rogers of the Evelyn Museum. Come on, help me out here. Well, anyway, Trigger, the horse that he rode, was stopped in the museum as well. We was in California for about a year when she got to visit the Grand Canyon, Painted Desert, Death Valley, and she got to see the London Bridge, which she probably forgets anyway, because she was less than a year old. And then from there, we went to Italy for 4 years. Now, when we was in Italy, she was enrolled by her mom in a preschool called an asilo. And this asilo, of course, everybody in there was kids, preschool kids, and they all spoke just Italian. And all the teachers spoke Italian. The Catholics run the school, so they had sisters there, but there were 2 sisters that spoke English. One was from this country, and I think one was from India. Anyway, I can remember an incident when her mom had cooked something, was putting it out on the table, and one of the dishes was the first one that ever hit our table. But she hadn't had it in the zeal prior. And she said, Dad, would you please pass me the pepper? Said, what? She said, would you please pass me the pepper? I said, would you point to it? I told her what it was in English. Because being in a school like that, she's so immersed in a foreign language, she had no idea what the English word was for. Anyway, what's going on here? We spent 4 years in Italy, then we moved to Germany. Another foreign country. But here she got to go to the American school. But because of the Air Force base I was stationed at in Ramstein, where we lived in Kusel, it was closer to an army base. So she got to go to school there. But she got to go there every day by bus. And it was here that she started to pick up drawing pictures, because one nice thing about having the kids like in Italy and Germany, they got to see, because we lived off base, they got to see no American TV. So the only American whatnot they saw on TV was usually the Disney films we talked about. That's all they got to see. Other than that, it was we couldn't pick up AFN or get the radio, but no, of the armed forces. So she she would take the covers of these videos, like Mickey Mouse and whatnot, and she'd start drawing. I thought it was very good. Anyway, we left England. I got out of the Air Force, and then we came to this country about 93. A couple years later, we all enlisted in a reenactment group. It was in this group that Evelyn was sort of put in charge of taking care of all the younger folk within this group. But there's a couple parents over there at that table who were glad that the Curry girls showed up to the reenactment, because their young ones, of course, they're not young now, were taken care of by Evelyn, Vanessa, and later on Dorothea. And let's see. From there, she went to Hartford University. Most of you know, we're back at that. And then from there, she found a degree in art. She did this, that, and the other. And then she saw on the internet that there was a school in South Korea where they pay the way there, pay the way back, as long as you had a degree from the stop. While she was in South Korea, she went there twice. She went to visit China, Thailand, Japan, the Philippines. Wow, not that good as well. Does it say here that you speak Spanish? No. See the dust in here. Anyway, before the last time she went to South Korea, when she met Jesus. And before he went out there, he had a visit to Arkansas, where he came and asked me for a hand in marriage. And I don't know, I thought something like that had died long ago, but it didn't. But right then I know Jesus was spot on. Years, Evelyn and I have had, all fathers and daughters, all fathers and sons, have had some disagreements. And one thing that always ended, that I would always tell her, however it goes through this disagreement or whatnot, that we were always on the same team. And then we'd cuddle up, and she used to have tears when she worked on my shoulder. She knew what I now, I'm like, well, you're on the same feet now. No, you are. You're a good son. And along with that, Jesus, I know that now, and even before now, that you have found a special key. Which give me a little line somewhere else. But you have the special key, alright? Now I'm going to read this as it appears on there. I like this one. Marriage is like driving along a road. The road can be nice and smooth. Sometimes it can be slippery. There can be obstacles in the way. We have to go around in circles, as you all know, especially in this country. Anyway, conditions can be bumpy. You can't see through the mist. But think before you cross the line, and beware of all the signs, and most importantly, excuse me. smell on the top shelf. I have to close my eyes. Okay. Excuse me, I'm 60, so I have to get out of the stool. Nothing wrong with 60. Anyways. Evelyn born, Vanessa born, Dorothea born, Alan born. Now it's because I'm there in this role of things that are very special to me. Now, do you have any something in the glass? This is the time young boy. So if you please be upstanding and raise your glasses. The last few are heartfelt words. When children find true love, parents find true love. Evelyn and Jesus, to you, to your love and your joy from this day forward. Evelyn and Jesus.
Evelyn and Jesus.